Welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about case teams. So similarly to opportunity teams and account teams, case teams allow people who are not the case owner or the record owner to collaborate on the case when you need help. So I like to use this example for case teams. Let's say that you are a very product heavy business and you have different technical products. I mean, this could be like Slack, or you could be someone like a bike product business. It doesn't really matter. But let's say you had a blue product that you needed someone who was specialized in the blue product to help you satisfy the customer with their issues on the blue product. You would want to have the product expert come on to collaborate on the case. So that's kind of a little spiel about case teams. Let's go ahead and jump into setup. So case teams are a little bit different than account teams and opportunity teams. They are automatically enabled in Salesforce. So what we can do is we can go in and set up roles and predefined case teams. So I'm going to set up some roles. I'm going to set up product expert is going to be one of them. They can read and write because they are an expert. Click save. You know what? I'm going to edit this and go ahead and have them be visible in the customer portal. And then I'm going to have executive sign off. Or just have the executive for the executive sign off. I'll have them also visible in the customer portal. You may or may not want that for them. So this is going to be in addition to the case owners. You may have just a regular a service person, a customer service person who is on this, and they won't be the lead. They'll just be the owner. But then we'll have two additional roles on here that are not going to be the case owner. They can read write to the case that they are assigned to. It's going to be the executive to have executive sign off if there's anything needed, as well as the product expert. So just a few quick examples that I've seen out in the wild, as some people say. Let's go ahead and set together a predefined case team. So for this, I'm going to have this be the blue case team. So for product expert blue, let's go ahead and have this be user. Jane Doe is going to be our product expert, and then I'm going to have this be me for the executive. So I'm on the case team, the blue case team for our predefined case team of blue. So now what we can do is, let's say a complicated case comes in where you need a product expert and an executive sign off for a particular case dealing with the blue product, we can have this predefined case team assigned to this case, and we'll be able to collaborate with Jane Doe, myself, and then also the case owner to work with our customers to get them going as soon as possible. So that is how you set up case teams within Salesforce. It's a little bit different than opportunity and account case teams because these are automatically enabled, but they work almost identically, just in a service capacity rather than a selling capacity. So thank you so much for joining me. If you have any questions on case teams, be sure to leave them down below in the comments. I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. Like, subscribe, check out the courses down below in the description box, and you can subscribe to the email list at salesforceemily.com. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.